Good morning, everybody. See, my friends, in the last class, we have started with this how to design the axial-led columns and all. And I gave you introduction about this columns and all. And we have got two types of ties, independent lateral ties and spiral or helical lateral ties. Or they are also called continuous helix, helix in the form of helix equal law. See, now, today we'll try to see why these lateral ties are important. What is the function? What is the function of these lateral ties? Baba, longitudinal reinforcement, I have said to that it will carry the load as well as wherever tension comes, it will take care. Okay, in a sense, whenever now this column is buckling like this, Baba, this reinforcement will take care of the tension. Okay, if it buckles like this, this longitudinal reinforcement will take care of the tension. Am I right, sir? So now, in case of a column, the load will be carried by concrete plus the longitudinal steel, whatever is there. Okay? That is one important thing that you have to remember. See, now, these lateral ties, whatever I have said, either independent lateral ties or these helical lateral ties. Okay, what is the function? Baba, function of these lateral ties are, Baba, in sense now, these lateral ties do not allow these longitudinal steel to buckle. Okay, say that example now. If I keep this longitudinal steel without these lateral ties, okay, if this longitudinal steel may buckle very, very easily because it's very, very thin. Is it not? Compared to this thing, it's very, very thin. So now, by tying these longitudinal reinforcement by means of these ties, okay, its length is going to become only this much. So but now, your longitudinal steel do not buckle that easily. Am I right, sir? So but now, the first and foremost function of your lateral ties is it do not allow the longitudinal steel to buckle. That's one thing. Second important thing is now, say like an example. In sense, in the formwork, you have placed these longitudinal reinforcements. You have placed. And now you are going to pour your concrete. But whenever you are pouring concrete, assume that lateral ties are not there. Then what happens is, during the pouring of the concrete, your reinforcements may become like this. Okay, they may go out of plumb. They may widen like this while pouring the concrete. So now, to avoid that one, what we do is now, we tie these longitudinal reinforcement by means of these ties. Okay, in a sense, now, by tying these longitudinal reinforcement by using these ties, but your longitudinal reinforcement will be in place. It will be in place. Okay? And the last and foremost important work what these lateral ties do is, but they impart something called confinement of the concrete. Okay? Confinement, I will explain you some other time. Okay? When your concrete is confined, automatically it becomes more ductile. It becomes more ductile and you know, it can withstand more earthquake loads. Okay? That's the reason why these lateral ties, either in the form of independent lateral ties or in the form of such helical reinforcement, is very, very important. Okay? So you know, a column without ties, you cannot do it. It's also an important element in the column. Okay, so another important thing what your IS code says is, okay, according to IS code, minimum longitudinal steel, in a sense, this is your longitudinal steel, am I right now? I have said you that, in the case of a square or rectangular column, okay, four minimum longitudinal reinforcement should be there. And in the case of a circular column, six longitudinal reinforcement should be there. This is your IS code specification. Along with that, what it says is minimum longitudinal steel should be 0.8% of the gross cross-sectional area, minimum this much steel you have to place. Baba, why means this minimum steel will take care of the buckling effect or the tension effect in your column. Okay? That's the reason why 0.8% of the steel is a must in any column. Similarly, baba, maximum steel also, in the sense of you cannot keep your longitudinal steel more than 6%. Because if you keep more than 6% of the cross-sectional area, then concreting becomes difficult. Concreting of this column becomes very, very difficult. So these are the two specifications your AS code gives. Okay? Thank you very much.